This is video one on the calibration of your new Medmont E300 Corneal Topographer. Start by acquiring the calibration device which can be found with your supplied materials. It looks like a small black metal plate with a ball affixed to one side. Insert the narrow end of the device up and into the forehead rest, securing it with the screw going through the practitioner side of the forehead rest, through the hole and into the metal plate. Once it's firmly affixed, open up your Medmont software, select Configure and Calibrate Instrument. A pop-up window will come up telling you that we need the serial number for your Medmont topographer. That serial number can be found on the right-hand side of your instrument. Enter in the serial number and select OK. If that instrument has never been calibrated before, it will also need the calibration file, which is found on one of the disks that are supplied with your Medmont. That disk says calibration file on it, as well as the serial number that's associated with your topographer. Once you have the disk in your CD or DVD drive, select OK and browse to that disk, double-clicking on the calibration file there. When the calibration file has been loaded, a calibration wizard will come up. Take the joystick and use it to center the instrument to the calibration ball. The instrument can be controlled laterally by moving the joystick nasal or temporal or right or left. Then rotating the joystick, you can move the green crosshair up or down. Move the instrument forward until the rings appear more clear, parallel, and even. Then look at that red distance indicator at the top of the runway. While the red line is at the top of the runway, the instrument is too far away from the calibration ball. While the red line is at the bottom of the runway, the instrument is too close to the calibration ball. Line up the green crosshair and the red distance indicator over the apex ring. The software will automatically capture when the instrument is in the right position. Click Next to continue taking your five captures. While the red line is above the green crosshair, you need to move the instrument closer. Center that unit with each capture until the software tells you a capture has been taken. You're going to take five readings. Once those five readings are done, the instrument can determine the error that presently exists and how to correct for it. When the calibration window brings up the option to calibrate now or continue to use the calibration, regardless of which it selects, whether it says calibrate now or continue to use the current calibration, if this is the first time you've used your Medmont topographer, select recalibrate now and next. The calibration will run from 5 to 30 minutes. Allow it to complete prior to using your Medmont topographer. This same calibration procedure can be used with each calibration that's required over the course of the life of your instrument. Every 6 months approximately, the instrument should be recalibrated. It should also be calibrated if it is bumped or jarred in such a way that you might be concerned about the accuracy of the unit. This concludes the video on calibrating your Medmont E300 Corneal Topographer.